LoveLine is meant for an adult audience. LoveLine may contain sexually oriented content.
Listener discretion advised.
Now, here's LoveLine.
1-800-LOVE-191.
With Dr. Drew and Adam Carolla.
What? Are you insane?
Hey, it is LoveLine. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Fax number 310-854-4455. Dr. Drew is a board-certified physician and addiction medicine specialist for the fifth time today. Our guest tonight is Robert Schimmel, who's really just an excellent stand-up comedian and a really good guy. Robert's been in here a couple of times. I saw him a couple of weeks ago on the Hollywood Squares. He has himself a new CD, which will be out December 7th. Also, it's called Unprotected, by the way. Also, a stand-up show of the same name, which will be on HBO, coming up this Saturday. So, Robert is actually doing stand-up right now, but he should roll in here any minute now. So, we'll expect him soon. Until then, we'll get to the calls. See, Drew, you don't have to say anything. That's the beauty of your job.
I can't, but
that's
hang on for
the beauty
one second.
Of your job. I don't hate you for it.
I know, but stop. If you'd like me to, I will be happy to.
No.
If you don't want me to.
It's an abortion when you talk.
Yeah, but don't give me grief for not doing it then, because I would be happy to.
I'm allowed
to
quietly despise you.
Yes, you are. But I would like to help you out and do it. Know that. And I'd be happy to do it any time.
I know.
If not every night.
Please.
Okay.
Shh. All right. Don't try to talk, man. just look the way you look.
Hey, How did you do with the Playmate video?
Oh, you know what?
What? Oh.
I have not had myself.
What?
Yet. My friends, Chris and Ray, I had to meet them for dinner. I'm still in the makeup. We taped the TV show today. Heather Kozar came by, the Playmate of the Year. What's that puss on?
Who's him?
Heather came by to the TV show today, the 1999 Playmate of the Year, and... I thought she looked real good. I mean, good. Better than I remember. Well, last time I saw her, she was on the radio.
Yeah.
But she looked foxy. And,
nice rack.
Yes. And I couldn't tell if they're fake or not.
She mentioned popping them in an accident.
Oh, really?
Remember she was talking about...
True. I'm trying to masturbate later, okay?
But you remember? You probably getting an accident or something. And
On the TV?
Yeah, she said, I'm going to lose some life or limb. And then you said, oh, you might hurt the breast. Don't do that. And she goes, yes, they could pop.
Yeah, but I don't think she was talking about her. She was talking about the caller.
Okay. No, because you kept saying to her, you could lose a limb, it'd be okay, but we can't have you have your breast hurt, remember?
Yeah, I don't know if that was a reference to them being fake or not.
Yeah, I wasn't sure.
It wasn't.
Okay.
And I'm going to pretend you didn't say that. And then I'm going to pretend she's actually in the room when I come home tonight. So anyway, I got hold of the Playmate calendar video, and there's just nothing better than sitting next to somebody for an hour talking to them and then running home and seeing them naked on the video. I mean, that's the best part.
That's why you do this job, isn't it?
That's why I don't ask for money.
Yeah.
No, I mean, seriously, anyone can go home, you know, go rent a Playmate calendar video and watch the Playmates frolicking, and that's exciting. It's titillating. You could, that would work out. But to sit next to one and talk to her for an hour and then run home and pop it in, that's livid. And as a matter of fact, that's as good as it gets, right? I couldn't get any better than that. You sit next to the girl, you talk to her for a whole hour, then you take a video image of her nude, and you go home and you masturbate. That's it, right?
It's the top.
That's the top. That is the pinnacle. I mean, is there a scenario that's better than that?
You go home with the woman you love, and who actually...
What? No. No. So, anyway, I had to go out to dinner after the show. I came straight here, so it's going to be, I'm going to be doing about 90 on the ride home tonight.
I'll be in your draft.
All right.
Back draft.
Jessica?
Yeah?
You're 16.
Yep.
What's up?
I've been on the pill for almost a year, and I didn't get my period for 2 months. And I went out, and I got a pregnancy test. My period has been, like, totally normal since I've been on the pill. And I went out and I got a pregnancy test, and it came back positive.
Wait a minute. Why did you get the test?
Because I didn't get
it. She missed her period for a couple of months.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay. Yeah. And I've been with my boyfriend for 3 months.
Uh-huh.
So I was wondering how I can go about dealing with this, telling my parents and telling my boyfriend. And
are you pregnant?
Yeah.
Oh, you are?
Yes.
Did you miss a couple pills or something along the way? Or take?
No, I made sure I took them every day.
Did you take an antibiotic or something like that?
Huh?
Were you taking an antibiotic or other medications?
No.
Well, how'd you get pregnant then? Mm-hmm. That pill is very effective.
I know. That's why I'm like...
Why have you been on the pill for 2 years?
No, for almost a year.
Oh, I don't know why. I thought it was 2 years. Why for almost a year? Were you have another boyfriend before this guy?
Yeah.
All right. And so you took it religiously, you took it at the same time, you weren't on any antibiotics, and you still got pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
That always sounds a little fishy to us, but we'll take your word for it, and you're pregnant.
And you want to know how to tell your parents?
Yeah.
That you're pregnant?
Yeah.
Do they know you're sexually active?
Yeah. My mom is the one that put me on the pill.
What are you planning to do with the pregnancy?
Abortion.
Well, you don't have to discuss that with them.
Huh?
You can do that on your own if you want.
I can?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Would you tell them anyway?
I don't... Probably.
Okay. Well, your mom seems like she's been pretty open about these things.
Would you
consider adoption for this child?
I don't know if I could go through the whole pregnancy and then give up a child after 9 months of, you know...
Okay, so you're going to get an abortion. Your mom is progressive, hip, or drunk and out of it. Either way, she put you on the pill. You didn't do anything wrong. You took the pill, and you got pregnant. So why don't you confide in her and see if she can't be a source of strength for you?
I think that's a great idea.
Okay.
Okay?
All right?
Okay.
All right, good luck, Jessica.
Bye.
Drew, do you believe people that say they took the pill religiously, didn't take any antibiotics, and still got pregnant?
Well, the stuff I've read about those sorts of phenomena suggests that there's something about the way they took the pill. They skipped it, didn't really pay attention, or they missed it, or they screwed up in some way but weren't aware of it.
You have to take it at the same time every day?
Theoretically, yeah.
I mean, but it could be 4 or 5 hours off, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Is it going to screw things up?
It shouldn't. It really shouldn't.
Are some women more receptive to the pill than others?
Meaning it works better?
Yeah. What I'm saying is, you know, let's say there's some women who have a certain biology where they miss a day or they don't take it at the same time each day and they don't get pregnant.
Right.
It just seems to be more effective.
Right.
And others need to be very, very consistent with it.
That is probably true.
All right. Eddie?
Yes.
You're 17. What's up?
Well, basically, I became sexually active about a month ago. And the first time I had it, it was unprotected. The second time, it was with a condom. And I can't tell whether I'm multi-orgasmic or I just didn't go, basically. Because that first time, I lasted well over half an hour. And I had to finish myself off. And then the second time...
Well over half hour, but not quite 35 minutes, huh?
Yeah. And I had to finish myself.
Well, the second had swept again past.
So you're saying it was maybe 31 and a half, maybe 32 minutes?
Longer.
Oh, boy. All right, so he's eclipsed the old 30-minute record he'd set for himself.
What I understand is how he considers himself multi-orgasmic if he can't orgasm and has to, quote, finish himself off.
I'm going to try to get back to his call, see how the phone is working. Eddie?
Yeah.
Well, that sounds better, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so your question again is you think you may be multi-orgasmic.
Yes, because the second time I had sex, I used a condom that time.
Yeah.
And I pulled out one time, about 20 minutes or so, and it was full.
And you weren't aware that anything had come out?
Huh? Yes, I wasn't aware of anything.
Okay, so you had an orgasm and weren't aware of it?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's pretty weird.
So, but how does that make you multi-orgasmic?
Because I was able to keep going.
Well, that just means...
It makes you 19.
It makes you 17.
Yeah.
It just means your penis, your balls quit long before your honker did.
Uh-huh.
But that doesn't make you multi. See, multi means more than one.
Well, I was able to have more than one.
Then you had another one.
These are multiple separate ones. Multiple orgasmic means one after the other, after the other, after the other, with no rest, no in between.
Yeah.
That's not you.
I mean, I did it maybe about three times. I had pulled out the second time.
Yeah, but the point is there was probably 10 minutes at least in between each, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that's not multi-orgasmic.
Okay.
No. All right.
There's right. 3 seconds in between each. It would be 30 seconds.
Okay.
Okay, Eddie?
All right.
I mean, you're doing good.
Yeah.
I mean, three.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, those days are long gone for me. Long gone. Although, I think I'm going for three when I start. You know, that's my thing. I'm going to get three off this time.
But doesn't that sort of pertain to everything, like sports and athletics? And you still think, in your head, I'm 22.
Yeah. Yeah, well, no. I mean, it's
skiing,
that. It's,
whatever it is.
It's that way with everything. It's that way with when I eat pie. I look at the pie, I go, I stare the pie down, I go, hey, pie, you're in a world of S, because I'm going to eat your entire ass right now. I get a jug of milk, and I sit down in front of the pie, and that's it. I'm demolishing the whole pie. I have like 2.5 slices, and I start to feel sick. Force, you know, the rest of the third slice in me, and then I lie down.
But when you were 17 and playing football,
I'd eat the entire pie.
The pie. I think it's anything physical as you get older, you keep thinking... As a 20-year-old.
Yeah, I entered a pie-eating contest at school and took the pie home with me. I told you this story, didn't I?
No.
Boy, this is really diabolical. I entered a pie-eating contest. They had like one of those...
I do remember this now. The teachers got all pissed off at you.
They had one of those like lunchtime shows where a bunch of kids got up in the pavilion or wherever it was in front of the whole school, and they were having some activities during lunch. One of them was a pie-eating contest, so me and two husky guys sat at the table, and they put the pie in front of our face, and you know they tie your hands behind your back, I think, and they go, ready, go, and you just bury your face into a pie. It's not really enjoyable for those of you who really enjoy pies like I do. It's a bit of a mockery, if you think about it.
Sure, it's making mockery of a pie in general.
And
it's making light of the pie.
The whole science of eating pies,
oh,
yeah.
Sure.
It's as if someone said, boy, like you're a connoisseur of wine, but you just busted the bottle top off and just chugged it. You know what I mean?
Licked it off the asphalt.
It's a little slap in the face.
Yeah.
So while everyone had their face buried in the pie, I just stared at my pie. I didn't touch my pie. I nibbled a little around the crust, and then I licked a little at the top. But I never put my face in. I never broke the crust. It was an apple pie. People were screaming, yeah, because there was money going around. There was some, you know, smart money on me. But I was not getting involved with this pie. And then some fat kid next to me won, and they held his hand up, and he was covered, you know, from chin to a hairline with pie. It was a mess. He was almost vomiting. And they declared him the winner, and there was still 20 minutes left in lunch. I picked my pie up, and I walked it home. And I only lived like 2 blocks from the school, and I just walked home with this full pie.
Did you say the teachers got all pissed off?
Mrs. Tomey, she got pissed. She said, you throw that pie away. You're not, where are you going with that pie? So I'm going home.
Away.
Going home to eat it. Eat it like a human being with a knife and a fork and a jug of milk. She said, she was so pissed off. She said, throw that pie in the trash can. So I held the pie up. And I said, Mrs. Tomey wants me to throw away this pie. It's perfectly good pie. And the place started like booing her. So she had like run for her life. And so I just took off with the pie and ran. I ran with my pie. It was such a coup for me to have an entire apple pie. I loved pie. I was constantly eating, and no one would buy me a pie at home.
Now, when you got home, I just tried to imagine the scene. Did you pour Count Chocula or Cocoa Puffs on it?
No, I didn't want to obscure the flavor of the pie. So I sat down. I got a jug of milk. I drank it right out of the jug. I got a knife and a fork, and I ate the entire pie.
Wow.
I went back, and I belched in Mrs. Tomey's face.
What did Mrs. Tomey teach?
She was just a counselor, but she'd had about up to here with me, because, you know, by then I'd been there for like 2.5 years, and she just, it was trouble. Ruth?
Yeah?
You're 19.
Right.
Yeah. I want to thank Mrs. Tomey. She's listening for all the guidance, which was nothing. Go ahead, Ruth.
Oh, okay, thank you. I got a problem. My boyfriend says he'll break up with me if I don't stop seeing my girlfriend.
Mm-hmm.
What do you mean, girlfriend?
Well, our parents are going to get married in about in a couple of months. I'm not sure exactly when.
So your future stepsister?
Yeah.
Wow.
What are you guys doing?
Stuff.
Oh my God,
man.
Yeah.
How old is she?
18.
Yeah. Why are you so chaotic? What's up with you?
Well, nothing.
Huh?
I mean, she's beautiful.
Yeah.
She's really great. And
Drew's handsome. You don't see me blowing him, I mean, on camera, do you?
No.
Okay.
I mean, well, I don't know. Is he going to...
Your boyfriend?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kind of possessive.
Well, no. I think this is a reasonable request. If he's going to be your boyfriend...
That you not have sex with your stepsister.
Or with anybody.
Well, no, it's not anybody. I mean, it's my stepsister, practically. It's not like it's a...
Okay, so it's a family thing.
Well, I'm not, like, sleeping with anybody else in my family.
Okay. Not yet. Hey, Ruth?
Yeah?
What is going on with you?
I wish you could hear what that sounds like.
Were you, anyone ever do anything to you?
No.
Is there manic depression in your family?
No.
Do you have a brain tumor?
Three. I was being sarcastic.
Good. I was believing you.
Oh,
this is brain tumor type activity. Anyone molest you?
No.
Really?
Yeah. Nobody did. Nothing has happened. I'm perfectly normal.
Where's your dad is marrying your girlfriend's mom?
Yeah.
Where's your mom?
My mom, she died when I was younger.
How old were you?
Yeah.
How old were you?
How old was I? About 8.
It's not too cool. What'd you die of?
Cancer.
It's awful. Right?
I wonder if that has any effect.
Yeah.
Oh, what kind of guy is your dad? Well, I mean, doesn't have to manifest itself this way.
Mm.
What kind of guy is your dad?
He's great. He's brilliant. I want to be just like him. I mean, he's brilliant. He's wonderful.
You do?
Yeah.
All right. And so it's been 10 years or 11 years since your mom passed away.
Mm.
And your dad just raised you himself?
Yeah. I mean, I had a lot of influence from my aunts and stuff, and my dad thought it was important for me to have female.
When did you lose your virginity?
When I was about 16.
About?
I'm sorry?
About 16?
Yeah, when I was 16.
Okay. How old was the guy?
21.
17.
When did you know you were into women?
Well, it's kind of recently, like in the last 8 months.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Well, it's not the women part. It's the fact that you insist on having sex with other people when you're in a monogamous relationship and that the person that is going to be a family member.
How old is your stepsister?
18.
Okay, and are you going to live together?
No, I mean, it's not like... No, she lives with her friends right now, and she's not going to move in. It's just...
Why does she live with her friends?
She doesn't get along well with her parents.
Surprising. Yeah. She's got some issues.
Is she the one that initiated this relationship with you?
Yeah, sort of.
Mm.
Does she have some issues, Ruth?
She's getting back at somebody.
No, she's pretty normal. She's really intelligent.
She's pissed at her mom, though, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, there you go. Payback time. Hey, Ruth?
So you think this is just a revenge thing for her to get back your mom?
Well, she's screwy. Listen, she's basically living away from home because she can't stand her mom or her biological dad.
Huh?
She has no plans of moving in with her mom and your dad?
Right.
So there's some issues there, wouldn't you say?
Well, I mean, she just doesn't get along with him very well.
And even my raising the question of her getting back at her mom by going after her future stepdaughter made some sense to you.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's a little screwy, this girl, but so are you, Ruth.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what's with all the acting out? Can't you mellow out a little bit?
I guess.
All right.
It's not that bad, though.
Ruth, it doesn't get much worse.
Break up with your boyfriend.
Or with your girlfriend. Or the other.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, you don't want to be in a committed relationship. You're not committed.
Yeah.
Maybe she can make a commitment. That's what she would... Kind of, she needs that right now, you think?
I don't know. I don't trust this guy. He's going to make her pay for this, you know. Listen, all you bisexual screwballs out there. You're not fooling me for a second. This is just another excuse to cheat. Not a bad plan, but when you announce to your partner you're bisexual, you're cheating. That's what you're saying. I'm going to cheat.
It's
And it's a little you're more confused. Yeah, it's, you're all screwed up.
It's
believe
a little
you
different
me.
Than cheating. It's saying I can't be intimate. I can't be monogamous. Right.
Yeah.
This isn't going
to
last.
I'd
I may
like
not cheat, but
I'm bisexual.
This isn't going to last. Is what that's saying. I mean, it may not be cheating necessarily, but it ain't going to last. And if you insist on being controlling and being uptight, then I'm going to cheat.
Yeah, I wish this ass was in vogue 10 years ago. I would have announced it at the beginning of every relationship. It's great, you know. And guys are pretty. You know, guys are like, well, all right, I still get a blowjob, right? Yeah, okay. Well, you get on with chicks, sounds great. Sure, but you're really explaining to them that you're not going to be with them for any
right.
real length of time or
real
in any real way.
Right.
All right, we're going to take a little break.
That's
when
perfect.
We come back. No, that was a nice burp. You smell that Indian food?
Oh!
Yeah. That's a little chutney for you, brother.
Oh, that's a little...
When we come back, that was some chutney. Later on in the show, I'll see if I can...
Hurry,
I can,
hurry.
I'll see if I can produce some buttney. All right. When we come back, we'll speak to Harmony. Long-distance boyfriend proposed, but... they will be apart for a while. Oh, please. Let's do something better than that, Drew. Who do we got over there? We'll talk to Elisa. Elisa's boyfriend cannot orgasm during sex 95% of the time. Let's know what's up. All right. That we can talk about after this.
You have 5 seconds.
With Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
2.
Back in a minute.
1.
So he'll come in when he comes in, and we'll be glad to see him. And until then, we'll go back to the phones. Elisa?
Yes?
You're 21.
Hi.
Hi.
I have a question for you.
Mm-hmm.
My boyfriend, I've been together with him for 7 months, mm-hmm. and the first time we had sex, he hadn't had sex in 3 years prior to me. And we had sex the first time without a condom 7 months ago.
How old is your boyfriend?
24.
And you've been with him for 3 years?
No, I've been with him for 7 months. He hadn't had sex before.
Oh, I'm sorry. My brain's all effed up tonight.
Yeah.
All right, he hadn't had sex for 3 years before that.
Yes.
There's a little dry spell.
Exactly.
So I built that record.
When we had sex for the first time, we did not use a condom. It was unprotected. And it took him 30 minutes to finish. Mm-hmm. And... ever since then, throughout this past 7 months, he will take long periods of time to finish, or he just can't do it at all. And even during oral sex, he's not able to finish. He gets very stimulated, and then he gets frustrated with himself.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not quite sure if it's due to him masturbating or his stress level, or...
some combo. What's he so stressed out from?
Work and school and, you know.
Well, he has issues because he had a 3-year dry spell.
Yeah.
Which is a pretty long drought.
How old is he again?
He's 24.
24, yeah.
Yeah, but this guy went from, you know, 20 to 23 without getting laid.
Yeah, that's true.
And why did he take that kind of time off?
He doesn't believe in having sex without a relationship.
Mm. Well, now we're starting to get somewhere.
Yeah.
Is he religious?
No. Right. No, no, no.
Can you turn the Stan Kenton CD down in the background there, Elisa? What is that? Who's playing the piano?
Piano. Okay, I'll go outside.
Where are you?
I'm in my house.
And you just have a piano?
Yeah, they're family members, you know.
Playing?
Instrumental.
Just sitting around playing the piano while you're talking about your boyfriend's inability to ejaculate?
Actually, it's in the other room, so nobody can hear me.
I'd be worried.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so, so did you say he was a religious guy?
No, he's not at all. He's,
I go back in the house, Elisa. I'd rather hear, I'd rather hear the piano than the freeway.
All right.
Thank you.
He also has,
yes,
with his testicles, he has on one side, one part of his testicle is swollen on the top part of it, and I'm not quite sure if that has anything to do with it at
all. It's probably normal. It's just an epididymis, and
I doubt. Would that cause him to not?
No, I really doubt it.
How often does he masturbate?
Actually, he hasn't since we've been in this relationship.
Are you sure of that?
He does it once in a while, like once a month, but because he's so frustrated with not being able to come,
yeah,
he has stopped just to see if that was the problem.
So it's been 7 months?
It's been 7 months of continuous not being able to do this, and when he does do it,
it's been 7 months of not masturbating?
Of not masturbating.
Okay.
Yet. In a while he
Boy.
Will.
Wait, anything
once in a while he will.
Question. Once in a while he will masturbate?
Once a month, yeah. As I said.
All right, well, you said he hasn't done it since you were in the relationship, and then he does it once a month. Okay, so once a month is how often he masturbates. This guy has some issues surrounding his semen.
Is he on medicine?
No, he's not.
Okay.
And there's issues here. He's 24. He masturbates once a month. That's never.
Yeah.
It falls into the, here's what the application says.
It's approaching infinity.
Once a day, twice a day, three times a day.
Never.
Never. There's not even a week category on there. There's not even a square that you could fill in for the once a week. I consider that never. That's never doing it.
Hmm.
You understand? I'm 35. This is 24. Once a month? 3 years off without it?
Well, it makes me wonder about the biology of what's going on here, whether he's got something else brewing.
Yeah.
Or is he lying? Or
no.
Let's put it this way. If it's not a biological thing, you would take a very, very serious concentration of the ninja to carry this out.
Right. Yeah. Okay, so who should he see? He should see a doctor, perhaps.
Yeah, for starters.
Who? What kind of
general
doctor?
General doctor.
Just general doctor and explain to him?
Mm-hmm.
He might send you to a specialist?
Correct.
Okay. Down with that. Harmony?
Hi.
Hi, you're 22.
Yeah, I have a question. I have been saying, I've known this guy for 5 years, and we've dated for the last year. He lives 5 hours away from me. And he asked me to marry him 3 weeks ago, and he's in the military, so I haven't seen him since 3 weeks ago. And
he's on top of some hooker in Bangkok right now.
Oh, he's not like that at all.
Uh-huh.
But the question is, I don't know if this is weird or not, but I'll go back and forth. Maybe I do want to marry him, maybe I don't. And also, if I decide, like I've been thinking about that I do want to. If I do want to, I don't want anybody to know about it. I don't want my parents to come over. I just want it to be like the small court, me and him thing that, you know.
Are you embarrassed by him for some reason?
No, I'm totally not. Like, I'm proud, actually, of him.
Why don't you want your parents over?
I don't know. It's weird.
Are they a pain in the neck generally?
Pardon me?
Are they difficult to deal with generally?
My parents? No, I talk to my mom like every day.
I don't understand this because most women are, planning for months.
I know. I talked to my sister about it. She thinks I'm totally weird.
Okay.
Well, what's going on? What do you think?
I don't know. I don't know if it's weird because I don't know.
When are you guys going to be able to see each other full time?
He should be back from the sub the end of this week. I'll see him this week, but then I'll still be in school for another year. And then after that year, I'll move down to where he is.
Is this the way you've always imagined?
So let me...
Yeah.
You'll see him full-time a year from now.
Yeah, but I'm okay with that.
And you want to get married first?
Yeah, and that way it'll just be easier on me, I think.
For him being away, knowing that you're locked in with him.
Not locked in, but just knowing that I'm basically secure with, I won't have to, worry if we'll ever get married or,
And is this the way you always imagined marriage to go for you?
I don't know.
Quiet.
I've never thought about being married before.
How come?
I don't know. I've been proposed to like 4 times. I've always immediately said no. Are you kidding? And then
what were you thinking then? What was your reason for saying no so quickly?
I don't know. Just
one
time, this guy asked me, and I'm like, no, I'm moving to the East Coast.
You better figure. I don't know is not an acceptable question when you're taking a major life step forward.
You're 22.
Yeah.
Give it a little time.
Yeah.
Graduate from college.
Until somebody can ask you a question, you'd answer the answers other than I don't know, which may be another 4 to 10 years.
Yeah. Yeah, she doesn't sound like she's that excited about it. I don't know what her rush is. I don't know if he's in a rush. They're not going to see each other for a year. He's in the military. She's still in college. Why bother?
Right.
Just take it slow. Tiffany?
Yes.
You're 24.
Yes, I am.
What is up with you?
I have a question for Dr. Drew.
Mm-hmm.
I was diagnosed with HPV about 2.5 years ago. It's been an ongoing battle for me that I'm not winning. And I've gone through, I'd say all told, about 60 treatments.
What do you mean treatments?
Pedophilin, trichloroacetic acid, cryocauterization, as well as 4 visits to the hospital for laser treatment.
Mm-hmm.
And I keep very abreast of any kind of new information, whatever I can get my hands on. I've heard of something called imiquimod, which I talked to my gynecologist. Mm,
it's for the man most. It's Eldara. It's for the outside.
Right. So I didn't know if it said on the internet.
It's for dipping, not for spreading, right, Drew?
It's for
dipping, not for dabbing?
Yeah, not for
pushing?
For, yeah, packing. It's for dabbing.
It's for jacking, not for packing.
There you go.
All right.
But I was just wondering if there's any other treatments you've heard of or are aware of that I might be able to...
Well, first of all, the newer data shows that these will burn themselves out by themselves eventually.
Really?
But yes. Tiffany sounds like she has a pretty aggressive case here because she's really doing a lot.
I do. I mean, this is the worst case my gynecologist has ever seen.
So you just got them all over the place?
Well, it's like I get them, they'll kind of go away for a while. As soon as my stress goes up, I'll get another outbreak. Even when we can control the actual lesions, I still come up with a class 2 pap smear.
Yeah, but that's a totally different issue.
Right. I mean, I haven't been able to.
Class 2 means you can drive a motorcycle or a truck. I can't.
Tractor trailer.
Tractor trailer?
Yeah.
Class 2 pap smear?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, in California or is that Nevada?
California. But Tiffany, here's the thing that troubles me the most about this is you have so much energy about this. I mean, this is an unpleasant thing, but it's easily manageable. You just got to go through these procedures and the pain in the neck.
Yeah, but she's got a bad case.
I mean, recently I had...
Hey, Tiffany? Drew seems like he doesn't believe you.
No, I believe her, but there are lots of bad cases out there. It doesn't have to take over your life.
Right.
All right. So here's the deal. All right, Tiffany. Yeah, I'm going to help you, and I'm not even a doctor.
All right.
By the way, your gynecologist is really earning his money.
Yes, he is.
You know, down there with
him. He's a great guy.
Oh, boy.
And that's good. At least you like seeing him, and that's a quality relationship.
Maybe she really likes seeing him.
No.
Okay, listen to me, Tiffany. There's no denying you got the warts, and that's too bad, and you got a bad case. But stress does bring these things out.
Yes,
and you got a lot of energy. You're a very high-energy person.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you're working on every medical advance goes right to your vagina. But how about you read a book, you meditate, you mellow out a little bit, you get a little therapy, you do a little of that Tai Chi or something.
We're doing all that stuff.
You are?
Doing the meditation.
Wow.
All that kind of great stuff.
All right. Well, that was my only answer is try to mellow out a little. And you kickbox. You get rid of a lot of that aggression. Drew, I don't know if you see any of these commercials that have to do with herpes or warts. Or there's a herpes medication out there now. Chick is kickboxing the entire time.
That's good.
It's great. She's in her own gym. There's no one else in it. You know, and it's
private gym.
Dramatically lit, by the way. You know, not like other gyms where they just turn the goddamn lights on. This is,
spotlights.
One spotlight down in the middle of the ring, and her and a trainer, and it's always a good-looking chick, and she's kickboxing, and it's always funny. I never know what the commercial's about. It's all these drug commercials. I never know what they're about until about 3/4 of the way through them. That's like, hey, this is some kind of kickboxing drug going on here. Turns out it's for herpes. It's for vaginal herpes or genital herpes. Then naturally, they always have to have this part, too. Good-looking guy throwing her the towel and coming to pick her up kind of thing. It's kind of let's weave the boyfriend in there. You're out doing your independent thing. You're kickboxing. You're proactive. You're taking on these lesions. You're kicking some lesion ass. But there's a softer side. There's an intimate side. And ultimately, we got to get rid of these lesions for the gents, don't we, ladies? Here's the good-looking guy in the bomber jacket. He's tossed you a towel. He's come to pick you up in his Porsche Boxster.
You haven't seen this commercial?
No, I'm not.
Oh, it's great.
Now.
Oh, it's
someone's got to send me a copy.
She's kickboxing, and then she's like running aggressively on a track, and it's really, you know, it's explaining the kind of person you are.
But Aldera, is interesting that Tiffany brought that up, though. That's a new cream, a new pomade, and it's very effective for external warts, not internal warts.
Mm-hmm.
And men can make good use of that.
All right. All right. Carmen.
Yes.
You're 24.
Yes.
What's up?
Well, I'm a preschool teacher, and one of the girls in my class, she's 4 years old, and she has a masturbatory problem. But it's not like, I know that it's very normal for this age group for boys and girls, but it's like she's on everything, and it's not like most of the girls that I know at nap time will just like lay on their hands, you know, kind
they
of
will.
Put themselves to sleep.
They wet themselves asleep?
Like, we'll lay on their hands, and we, you know, and she'll put herself, they'll put themselves to sleep while we rub their backs.
Are their hands under their head or under their groin?
Their genitals. The girls, anyway. But this girl, she straddles things. Dolls.
Well, yeah, well, I mean.
Straddles dolls.
It could be within the realm of normal. However, it is also a sign of severe emotional distress.
Emotional stress?
Yeah.
It'd be like. Like physical stress too, like, or, you know, I'm just,
something awful may be going on in the home.
Okay. That's what, you know, I'm just really concerned because, you know, I'm a mandated reporter, you know.
I'm not saying that she's necessarily being sexually abused, but just extreme stress, distress emotionally in the home can cause kids to start doing weird stuff sexually.
Because it's just, you know, it'll, you know, a lot of kids do it, but it just, like, it seems to me like it's just.
Carmen?
Behavior where she's
yeah, right. I think we get it.
Yeah.
We get it. I think there's probably this.
I think Carmen's used to talking to 4-year-old. Put the jacket on. Put the jacket on. Put the jacket. Put it on.
Adam, you don't need to go there with me.
We already went there, sister. Okay.
But Carmen, you look into this. There's something going on, and see, you know, this family needs some help.
Yeah.
Maybe there's a bunch of kids. Who knows what's going on, but. But you might be of help to them, assistance.
Who does she report it to?
I would start with just within the school and then get a hold of mom and see what's going on. She doesn't have to report to social services just unusual behavior by a child, but it's nice as a community to rally around this family, take a look, see if there's something that can be done to help them.
Do all 4-year-olds diddle themselves quite openly?
A little bit, yeah.
Like in class and stuff?
I don't know about classrooms, but they will touch themselves rather regularly.
Yeah. Yeah. I guess they just do what you do, what you learn not to do. You know what I mean? Don't they?
Yeah,
you know what
they probably have, you know, the brain is developing at that point, and they probably have a little kind of energy all of a sudden there.
Sexual?
Not sexual, but just there's something, you know, some sort of circuitry opening up, and, you know, they start doing that.
Yeah, but don't you just learn not to touch yourself in public?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I got the deviated septum, so I used to drool.
Yeah.
Because I hang my mouth open so I could breathe.
You learn not to do that?
People start calling me stupid.
Yeah.
So then I just learned to shut my mouth when I was standing around so I wouldn't look stupid.
You turn blue then?
I just, you know, sort of take a little air and then shut my mouth for a little while.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, if no one was around and I didn't care, I'd probably just let my mouth hang open.
God, you must be quite a sight in your house. You're in your bathrobe, drooling, watching the Playmate video.
Hand down the pants, possibly both hands down the pants.
Do you wipe at home?
With, huh? Wipe what?
Whatever. I just go
not right. If I think I'm going to take a shower at some point.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? If I go number two.
And, of course, it's just like peanut butter on a carpet with you anyway.
Right? Yeah, you can't get anything out of there. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you can wipe, but all
have
it does is all it does is work the stain in.
Have you gotten that toilet seat set up yet?
Oh, I got to make a move with that toilet seat. I'm going to write that down. I need the toilet seat that squirts in my ass. I got to get that thing. All right, that's it.
All right.
Okay. We'll take a little break. We'll be back.
Loveline. Be right back in a minute.
This is Loveline on Outrageous Talk Radio, 100.7 The Buzz.
It is Loveline. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. I was just yelling at Dr. Drew about the goddamn garbage man that's going to show up at my house at 6:25 tomorrow and wake my ass up with that banging and clattering and that beep, beep, beep when they put the thing in the reverse. I got a few things to say. One, the beep, beep, beep when any vehicle gets thrown into reverse. You know, garbage trucks, street sweepers, whatever. Every single goddamn vehicle seems to have the beep that goes off. Now, I know it's so people don't get ran over, but you know what? What about natural selection? Is it all right if a couple of people get ran over each year? It's fine with me. My life has been destroyed by the beep, beep, beep. Somebody somewhere is throwing something into reverse when I'm trying to roll over and get another couple hours sleep, and there's that goddamn beep, beep, beep. And they're not running anyone over. Let's get rid of that. Number two, I want the garbage man to come to my house about 4 in the afternoon. I want to schedule my garbage man because I pay so much in goddamn taxes. I don't want to be woken up at 6:30 in the morning. Let him go down the hill and wake up the poor people who don't pay taxes. That's my thought. Any of you have a problem with that, you can kiss my hairy ass. All I do is pay taxes. I don't use a school. I never call 911. I've never been to the hospital. I don't do anything. Certainly don't use the libraries. I don't use the cops. I don't use anything. I just get my ass woken up at 6:30 when the garbage man comes by. I want my own personal goddamn garbage man to follow me around and pick up anything I throw out of my car window. That's what I want, the amount of taxes I pay. Please, and listen, all you screwballs out there in society who hate people that make money, we're floating your lazy ass. So don't hate us. You'd be driving on cobblestone if it weren't for us. Sons of bitches. I include my entire family in that group I'm yelling at, by the way. Lazy, no-count people don't pay any taxes. And listen to me. Here's how I want society set up. I don't want everyone to kiss my ass because I paid 500 grand worth of taxes last year. I want it to be set up like a casino. You know, my dad probably paid 4 grand worth of taxes last year, the amount he makes. You know what I mean? Maybe him and my stepmom, they combined their stuff together. They probably paid $7,500 worth of taxes last year. All right, $7,500. I paid $500,000. Okay? That puts me in the executive club. That's the way I look at it. I want the gold card. I want the platinum card. I want to be like the guy who goes in the casino. You treat my dad the way the guy who dropped $3,500 last year, and you treat me the way the guy who dropped 500 grand would be treated. I guarantee there'd be a little difference in the way I was treated, starting with the garbage man. I want the garbage man who's going to my house tomorrow at 6:25 tomorrow morning to rouse my ass, go to my dad's house and wake his ass up. Then come to my house about noon when I'm good and ready for you. Listen to me, Anderson. Where's that sound effect? I want that goddamn thing ripped out of it. I swear to God, I want to strangle you every time I hear that goddamn thing. Delete that thing, please. All right, Drew, where the hell were we? Oh, kill that Anderson when he plays that junk. Makes you miss Engineer Mike. Oh, remember Mike? He was good looking. Tyrone?
Yeah.
You're 16.
Yeah, what's up?
What is up?
I had a couple questions for Dr. Drew.
Yeah.
About 2 days ago, I was over at my friend's house, and my girlfriend was over there. And I was taking a shower, and she came in and put on a condom, but I didn't know if it was going to rip or not. And I was wondering if condoms are right to use in the shower.
That's fine.
It's fine?
They are? Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right.
And I also have another one. Which ones are, like, more prone to rip? Someone told me that the ones that are ribbed are.
I don't know that. You know what? You check. We actually are doing a condom. I don't we have it up yet? A condom review on drdrew.com.
Really?
Check in the...
Is your penis going to be in them?
No.
No?
I'm trying to think where we have this. I think we have it in one of the article archives, but we're getting information from Consumer Reports, which is the other place you can go for this, and they'll tell you up to the date what's the, you know, how things measure up.
All right.
Cool. Hey, Adam?
Yeah.
Praise on, brother.
Thank you. Thank you, Tyrone. Is praise on's good, I think.
What's that mean?
I don't know, but it's good. Hey, Drew?
Yeah.
Do you think there's a correlation between the cost of condoms and their quality? Does that make sense?
Perhaps.
It's like power tools.
It would make sense.
So, you know, that's going to be the best extra $1.80 you ever spent in your life kind of thing?
I don't know that makes that big a difference. Again, that's why Consumer Reports help, but also compares price and whatnot.
And do they do that thing with the red dot and a half circle?
Yeah,
and,
yeah, yeah.
If any of the folks from the Consumer Reports magazine are listening, and it's a fine publication, let's go ahead and revamp the circle, the half circle, the circle with the red dot half full in it. What is that? Just go from 1 to 5, would you, you idiots? I swear to God, my head explodes reading those things. You ever look at that?
Yeah.
Well, this one, let's see, the transmission on the 85 Toyota truck only got a circle, but not a red dot, but there's a black truck, black dot on the Nissan. Just put a number. That's what they need. I need to lecture businesses. Jeff?
Yeah.
You're 27.
Yeah.
What's going on?
Yeah, I got a question and a comment. Mm-hmm. A question for Dr. Drew and you.
Yeah.
Go.
Okay, well, first off, for Dr. Drew, I got this sore in my nose, and, well, it comes and it goes, you know, it's been doing it for, like, over the last couple of years.
Has anybody ever cultured it?
No, I've never been to a doctor about it, nothing like that.
That's what you need to do.
A few years. So next time it kicks in, go down to the doctor and let him do a culture.
Okay.
They can be, it can be viruses, and there is a new herpes cream just came out this week.
Ooh.
It's better than Zovirax.
What it could be, though?
No, it could be a herpes type virus. It could be an infection, like a strep. It could be even a tumor. I mean, you get little growths in there that need to be taken care of.
So all right, so get it cultured. What's your comment?
Oh, well, my comment is, you know, I think you're pretty cool and everything. but
all right, thank you. Well, that was his comment. Right? No. Go ahead, Jeff. Hurry.
You know that you broke the third commandment 8 times since you came back on the air.
Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife?
No.
Which one?
Blasphemy.
What'd I do?
Blasphemy.
Shut up.
What'd I say?
Well, you cursed in God's name.
Oh, that's all right. Listen, Jeff, he doesn't exist, brother. You'll be fine. Okay?
Yeah.
All right, I'll see you in hell. Robert Schimmel, the very funny, but less punctual than we'd like. Robert Schimmel's coming here. We're going to take a quick break, and then he'll be here to breathe new life into a very dead show after this.
Love Line. Phone number is 1-800-LOVE-191.
We'll be right back.
Today. A quick 10-second timeout. We'll be back with more of the show in just 10 seconds.
This is
Radio
Station.
You're listening to our 100.7 The Buzz.
All the stars. All the entertainment excitement you're looking for is right here.
KQBC Seattle.
What does that mean?
Robert Schimmel, a very funny stand-up, is with us tonight. Robert has done the radio before.
Yeah.
I think a couple times before, actually.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Robert was here not too long ago on the radio, though. I saw him when Jimmy and I, my funny partner, Drew, when we did, although not
no,
funny
no.
on that day.
Your talented partner.
My talented partner when we did Hollywood Squares a couple of weeks ago, and I think it's running this week. And
yes, it is.
Robert, who we're big fans of, was in a square somewhere next to ours. And he had a couple of Louis Anderson jokes on the show that I thought was real funny, but I don't know if everyone else thought it was real funny.
Do you remember after the first one they stopped and they had a little huddle and they were talking? What did you say?
Yeah, what was the setup?
The question was, well, first, I couldn't believe how that lady, somebody had 2 X's in a row, and then the lady said, Robert Schimmel, and that one wasn't even to block.
Right.
Remember that? I don't know why, but she picked me, and the question was, if you're reaching for your Mashie or your Niblick, what activity are you involved in? And I said, playing Twister with Louis Anderson. And all of a sudden, they stopped.
Yeah.
Hold?
Yeah.
because Louis tapes Family Feud there.
Uh-huh. Right. So yeah, they were having a tough day all the way around between me and Jimmy and Rob.
They wouldn't let us sit together.
They told me that me saying that Jimmy's wife would not perform orally on him is unacceptable or perform oral sex or something. And then there was another question that came up for Robert that Louis got woven
Was,
into.
The term, yeah, so after that they said we're going to ask you another question. And then the question was, a pig in the poke refers to what? And I said, spending a night with Louis Anderson. And Whoopi Goldberg ducked behind her square.
Yeah. Yeah.
She didn't want to be seen.
I was laughing, though. I thought...
Oh, the whole grid was shaking. Everybody in there thought it was funny, but in the audience...
I think they may have, yeah.
And I think I went a little too far. I think they bleeped me or they cut something, because I think I said that... Because the audience went, whoa! And I said, what? He really is fat, though, right? And I said that Louis was so fat that I talked to him. I remember I talked to him once, and I said, Louis, you're a great guy and everything, but for someone to, like, perform oral sex on you, you'd have to lay across two chairs, like, facing down, and the person would have to roll underneath on one of those things the car mechanics use.
Creeper.
And he said, it's nice to know you have it all worked out. So, and they thought that was inappropriate for...
Well, let's not live in the past. Let's plug the future. That's what I
told
say.
My parents I was in Hollywood Squares, and they said, but that's not the real one.
Oh, yep. That was my... Actually, for me, it was my grandparents. We were talking about this. My grandfather's favorite show was the Hollywood Squares. I mean, watched that for 20 years, so I thought if his grandson came over and told him he was going to be on the Hollywood Squares, it would blow his mind. But it was kind of, yeah, and then my grandmother said, it was really funny. She goes, I turned it on the other night, and I saw you on there. How was I? You didn't say anything. I think you said something, but it was unsolicited. Meaning I just yelled into someone else's square, and then she got bored and changed it before I got called on.
I thought they would give you the real answers, and they don't. They only give you the bluff answers.
The crappy bluff
answers.
Yeah,
and right. Then the jokes that they write.
Right. But those don't involve Louis Anderson. That's where Robert made his alterations. Unprotected is the name of the CD and the name of the HBO special. That'll be the HBO special's this Saturday.
Premiere Saturday night, and the CD comes out December 7th, Pearl Harbor Day.
Right.
I don't know why they decided on that, but...
I don't think most Americans know.
Really?
Well, they do because they announce it that day on the radio, but other than that... I think it's apropos. And Saturday is the big fight, but the fight should be over by 10 o'clock. Yeah. That's the way I'm looking at it. Fight should start about 8 or 8:30. Is the fight on... The fight's a pay-per-view fight, right?
Yeah.
All right,
yeah.
So you watch the fight, then you switch immediately over to HBO, and you watch Robert Schimmel, who really, really is a funny stand-up. And I first got turned on to Robert about... Well, you know what it was? It was about 2.5 years ago when I was going to Florida to do a pilot with John Ritter. Remember that, Drew?
Yeah.
Ordinary Extraordinary?
Mm-hmm.
What an abortion that turned out to be. But I took Robert's CD with me because I was on the plane and I knew I was going to be bored and I didn't even know who Robert was, but I thought this might help me pass the time. And I listened to it 5 times, laughing out loud each and every time. And your career's really taken off. I mean, in the last just, would you say, 2 or 3 months?
Yeah.
You've been everywhere?
Yeah, I don't know what's happening.
I mean, literally, you don't, do you?
I don't
know where you are.
I really
do
don't. I was on Conan.
I saw you on Conan.
Boy, they let me get away with murder on Saturday.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, was that last night or the night before?
2 nights ago. And yeah. Denise Richards was on. Boy, what a talker, huh? So,
she's a great actress, too. Denise Richards is really hot. And, you know, it's funny. I thought she was hot when she did the Starship Troopers movie. And you know what's funny about guys? I don't know if you've ever done this, Robert, but I've claimed her for my own because I thought she was hot 2.5 years ago. So whenever her name comes up, like with a bunch of guys sitting around, oh, Denise, she's so hot. And I always go, hey, excuse me, but I knew she was hot 2 years ago, so, all right? And it's like, as if I have a better chance of getting in her pants because I masturbated to her 2 years ago when she did Starship Troopers, and the other guys didn't catch on to her until she did Wild Things 8 months after that.
I walked into her dressing room, and she was just got out of a shower and was in a robe.
No way.
Yes, at the Conan show, and I walked in, asked for an autograph, and she said, sure. And she was standing there in the robe. And
wow, how'd she look?
She looked okay. I said, you know, I'm a big fan of the both of you. I mean,
She's real good looking, but I don't know if she's a good actress because I've seen these Bond commercials. They're 5 seconds long, and her acting is distracting in it. Like, have you seen any of these Bond commercials
yet? Yeah, doesn't she play like a nuclear physicist or something?
Oh, boy.
Doesn't she?
I was explaining this last night, Robert, and I'm not going to go in great detail about it anymore, about how what Hollywood does with beautiful women. But here's what I was saying last night. Beautiful women get roles as beautiful women, not as physicists in real life. You know what I mean? There's no real hot-looking physicists, and there's no Russian ballistics experts that are really hot, because all you got to know is, what does Denise Richards really do for a job? Model, actress. And the best example I could think of last night
Tia
was... Tia Carrera, yeah, right. No, I was talking about, what's her name from Friends?
Jennifer Aniston.
Jennifer Aniston. You know, she does a sitcom where she has a lot of trouble getting a date. This is Hollywood fantasy world. But in real life, she goes out with Brad Pitt. So, you know what I mean? That's all you really need to know. Real life, Brad Pitt. TV, can't find a date. Okay.
It's always like that. Elle McPherson was on TV once. Remember, she said that. She said, you know, I can't find the date. No one ever asked me out.
Right.
Because you can't get through the security guys.
That's right, who are dry humping her leg. Jared.
How you guys doing?
You're 24.
That's it.
What is up?
Well, I got a question for you guys.
All right.
I've been with my girlfriend for about 4.5 years. Excuse me. And for the last 2 years, she's been an exotic dancer. Been cool with that, no problem. And about 6 months ago, she was approached by a guy that was doing an internet service, and we went down and did it, and that was fine.
Did what?
Pictures. Uh-huh. Porno pictures and things like that.
And you went with her?
Yeah, we did it together. We did penetration, all that kind of stuff.
Oh, you did?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Fine with it. So we haven't talked to the guy in probably about, it's been about 6 months. And we just contacted him again.
How much did you get paid for?
$500 for me and $500.
We paid him.
Yeah, he paid.
Five for each.
Yes.
All right.
Okay, so now we contacted him again. We were interested in possibly doing the internet service again, and he said he's not really doing that right now. He's going into movies.
Mm-hmm.
So he asked us if we would be interested in it. So that's my question. I don't know whether, I mean, we did the pictures, but now we're going to be doing a full-length feature film.
Yeah.
With her and I doing it, and he asked her if it would be okay for her to do it with guys also, and she said no. Girl on girl, or me and my boyfriend and another girl would be okay. But right. Me personally, my morals, I don't know if I want to go to this level now. It's questionable.
Hold on, what morals?
Mm-hmm.
Your morals?
There you go.
How much digging do you got to do to get at your morals? I mean, they got to be at least 6 feet under.
Oh, now stop it.
All right.
Did you do any drugs, Jared?
No, sir.
Would you like to?
No. Do I like to?
You said you already did the full hardcore internet pictures. Yeah.
That wasn't a movie, though. That was the photographer and my girlfriend, and that was it. Now we're talking. possibly, you know.
You have a very young, boyish voice, Jared.
If you see me, you would probably say the same thing. I don't look 24, but I really am.
Hmm. Are you hung?
Yes. Italian stallion all the way, and that's one of the things I love about you.
Yeah.
You are Italian also, aren't you?
Yeah, but I'm not hung, so that's where we part ways.
Jared's girlfriend is there with him.
Yeah, she's
she is?
To the radio in the other room.
How does she look?
Yeah.
She hung?
She's tight.
Good.
You would like her. You would be very much impressed.
Oh, well, I encourage you to make this movie. put her on the phone. Let me get to the bottom of this. All right. Oh, this guy's very secure.
He sounds like he's talking on one of those phones where you could change the voice.
Concerned with her with the other girl because we've done threesomes before, which is not that big of a deal. And I've heard Drew give his opinion about, you know, getting a third person in the relationship, which is really not healthy.
Yeah.
Me personally, I don't really have a problem with it.
Of course you don't, Jerry. Let us talk to your girlfriend now.
Yeah. Oh, you want me to get her?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah, untie her and put her on the phone, would you?
Hold on.
Okay. Oh, boy.
Jessica, they want to talk to you. Come here.
Boy, this guy sounds like a lawn jockey.
Hey, hold on. Here she comes.
Porn star.
Is it okay if I listen in, too?
Sure.
Okay. Here. close the door so they can't.
Yeah, right. But you have to be on your knees.
Okay, this is...
Hello?
Hello, what's your name?
Jessica.
Jessica.
Yeah.
All right, so do you want to do these porn movies?
Yeah, I don't mind doing them. I'm more concerned about him. He worries about it a lot. And
does he worry about you?
I'm not really sure if he worries about me or if he... I kind of think he might be a little embarrassed.
What about just, aren't you worried that once you get in, you won't get out, you'll just get swept up into the whole porn lifestyle, you're being a, you know...
I mean, how far is this thing going to go? I mean, I got to draw a line in the sand somewhere, right?
Yeah.
Well, to some extent, I would say I'm worried about that, but I'm also, I have a pretty good head on me. I know, you know, you can only... go so far with
Jared. What's I mean, Jessica, what's going on that you're an exotic dancer and you have to have this
what's
kind
that?
Of I'm talking to Jessica.
Oh.
What where did you what happened to you that you need this kind of power over men? Exotic dancing.
Well, you know, honestly, I've some things have happened to me.
What happened?
Well, I was kind of sort of I was sexually assaulted.
See, this is what ruins the whole porn thing for me now.
But honestly...
Because now I just picture a bunch of victims and some stepdad cornering them in a basement somewhere 15 years ago.
You were sexually abused.
Robert's come undone, by the way. He's punchy. He's on the ground. He's lost it completely.
And honestly,
you were five?
Gotten over it.
Wait. People don't just get over that, Jessica. They turn into, they become dancers and they get into porn movies as a way of dealing with that.
You are ruining Jared's bread and butter now with this psycho babble. You know what he's talking about, right, Jared? Okay, listen, you two aren't going to have any kids, are you?
Not anytime soon, no.
Okay, do you want to get married?
Sure.
Eventually?
Yes.
Sure.
Well, what would you say after 4.5 years? I definitely do. That's why I want to make sure that, you know, we're going to have a long-term relationship before I get married, because I hear all the time Drew talking about, you know, kids having kids a young age. She's 19, I'm 24. I did a little cradle robbing, I can admit that, but we've been...
How long have you two been going now?
4 years.
Good. 4 years?
4.5 years. We're coming up on 5 in April.
So she was like 14 and three quarters when you met her?
And he was 19.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
This is bad news.
Hey, Jared, and why is it, fair that I go to hell, too, when guys like Jared are in there? You know what I mean? Shouldn't there be different levels of hell? Shouldn't it be in, like, lingerie where Jared is down in plumbing, like in the basement or something? Is that fair? You know what I'm saying? It doesn't seem right that there's just one hell. Just hell. And just, I said, God damn it, and whacked off 4 years ago. I'm in with Jared.
4 years ago? 4 minutes ago.
Four times a minute ago. Whatever it was. The point is you know,
there's
I'm
the bowels
a good guy.
Of hell. There's the bowels of hell.
Oh, yeah. Jared will be in the bowels of hell while I'll be in the sort of penthouse, the upper echelon of hell.
Jared has sort of groomed this young lady into all sorts of things.
Oh, boy. All right.
I'm sure he's very happy with it. But, boy, this is exploitation.
What can we do? There's nothing we can do.
Nothing we can do.
Just Jared, watch my HBO special Saturday night, 10 p.m.
Yeah. That's right.
That's what I'm here for.
Robert's completely lost it. That's fine. I know what it's like, because Robert's been up since 5 in the morning, and what happens is you get punchy. You lose, first you lose control of your face, and then you lose control of your ass. That's the way it works. You get punchy, you don't know where you are, you lose track of time.
I'll be out of here before I lose control of my ass. Don't worry about it.
Well, Adam...
Yeah, he did a little damage in the men's room earlier. I think the ants has spoken once tonight already. I really do. Let's hope it doesn't pipe up again. Josh?
Yeah.
Yeah, what's going on? It's funny when you walk into the men's room and you smell the air freshener in there strong, you know, and you think...
It's hysterical.
Yeah, well, what I mean is your first impulse is, maybe the guy just sprayed the air freshener in there. And then you take a few more steps, you go, nah, there's a reason. I understand
especially
why.
When it's that herbal. All it does is make it smell like someone took a dump in the woods.
it's like someone took some crap and rolled it in potpourri and threw it against the wall. That's basically what it smells like. Josh?
Yeah.
You're 17.
Hi, I'm a long-time listener, first-time caller.
All right.
It's the man show, frequently.
Oh, thank you.
Love it.
Great.
Well, my question is, and my sister doesn't believe I'm listening, so I just want to say hi to Caitlin real quick. But my question is, I'm in a relationship with this girl, her name's Leah, and we go to school together, and nothing's really developed yet, but she does have an STD, and she's like a nympho. if we have sex.
But you guys are waiting for a while.
I wanted to know what the what happens if I get herpes.
What do you mean, what happens if you get herpes?
Well, I don't know what herpes does exactly.
It's a recurrent rash on your penis.
You can't get rid of it.
Really?
Little blisters that coalesce together and ulcerate. I'm to Robert. He's gone. I'm calling 911.
Robert's on the floor.
I'm going to call 911 a second.
You can aspirate him, can't you?
I don't want to, though.
You can resuscitate him, though?
I could.
Hey, Drew, put your wallet in his mouth so he doesn't swallow his tongue, would you? Hey, Josh?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, she has herpes.
Yeah.
You got to wear a condom then.
You still could get them, though. But you want to avoid being with her when she has an outbreak, no matter what.
Uh-huh.
And wear a condom the rest of the time. And if you get it, you get this recurrent rash that's infectious to other people.
Uh-huh.
Won't hurt you.
Of course.
But it's unpleasant and painful and you know, not one of the greatest things you can acquire.
Our guest.
For a woman, it increases the risk of cervical cancer. That's why it's a big issue for them.
Robert Schimmel dropped a tab of peyote before he came into the studio.
Tab?
He ate an entire peyote cactus.
A sheet of acid. What are you talking about?
Unprotected.
You have to look and see this.
They'll be out December 7th, and of course this Saturday is the big HBO special. Let's hope you laugh half as much as Robert's laughed in the last 5 minutes. He's coming undone. Drew, seriously, keep an eye on him from a medical standpoint.
I'm 911, I swear to God. We've got to get an airway in here.
Robert has been up since 5 a.m. and has just completely lost it. And, Drew, you know how it is. You get punchy. I know you don't lose your composure, but I certainly do. Chris?
Yeah.
You're 16.
Yeah, I am.
Robert's going to try to climb back up to the microphone.
I'm afraid what Chris might do to him, though.
Right on, dude.
Chris, go ahead.
Hey, before I start, I got to give you guys some praise, all right?
All right.
All right. Adam, the man show is sick.
Oh, good.
And the X show, the posers.
Yeah.
I feel like throwing my shoe at him.
Go. Please do. Like Elvis. Just
you
toss it right at the set.
Drew?
Yeah.
Your website? I actually have never been there.
That's good.
I don't think I ever will, so... But I'm sure you're helping a lot of people with it.
All right.
That's quite an
endorsement.
Thanks for bringing that up, Chris. Yeah. The ringing endorsement.
And the funny guy?
Yeah, Robert.
Not sure who you are or what you do, but what you've said so far is pretty funny, so I give
He's
you
He's lying on the ground laughing. He hasn't said anything.
Hey, funny guy. Hold on, this Chris, he's all full of compliments. Chris, like, Adam, really enjoy the man show. Drew, let me give you a compliment. Your website?
Never seen it.
Never seen it.
Never will.
Not gonna. No interest in it. But I'm sure you help some people. Funny guy, lying on the floor, laughing real hard. Don't know who you are, but you said some funny stuff. So you're okay with me.
Oh, Chris.
Hi, Chris. Now,
what's your question?
Everyone's been taken care of.
In my world religions class, I heard this thing about from Kama Sutra about somehow like retaining your chi through pinching the bottom of your penis when masturbating or something like that.
This is this public school. This can't public school, is it?
No, private.
In world religion class, they teach you about retaining your chi.
Yeah.
Anyways,
I remember when I was a kid, I had the pop-up Kama Sutra. You ever see that?
It's great.
Yeah.
Well, anyways.
Almost lost an eye once when I realized. So, Chris, you're looking into retaining some of your chi?
Yeah.
Let me tell you what my high school plan was. Lose the chi. Get rid of as much chi as humanly possible. A little chi here, a little chi there.
Here, chi there, chi.
A little chi on the pet. We call that a chi a pet when I jack off on the dog. I had a trail of chi going from the high school into my bedroom. That's how I found my way home for the first 6 months.
Right on. Well, I don't care about my chi.
Right.
Ball size or, I guess, medium.
Medium ball size? I put you down for medium ball size?
I guess so. I don't
know. I'll tell you, though. Let's get you a large pair of underpants in case the balls grow. Okay.
Oh, God.
All right.
Anyway, what I heard is that if you pinch the bottom, it recirculates.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it's for Dr. Drew.
It just goes up into your bladder. It goes up into your bladder when you push up behind your testes?
Behind my testes.
Yeah, it goes into your bladder.
Okay.
Doesn't
you don't belch up your own chi.
No, chi doesn't stay with you.
No, that's what they call the retrograde ejaculation.
Right.
Yeah, it's like the smokeless ashtray. You know, it's like you got a penis, but nothing comes out. It's great. It's great for long road trips, camping, places where you don't want a lot of semen flying around. I don't understand that. My whole thing is let's lose the semen, not see how much of it I can re-ingest into my system. And that makes you gay. I may be old-fashioned, but I don't care whose semen you're taking. You're taking on semen. You know what I'm saying? All right. Hey, Robert, I told Drew I was so anxious to get rid of my semen once that if I could run backwards fast enough and it came out, I would do it. All right. It's great to have Robert when he's vulnerable.
Oh, my God.
All right, we're going to take a break, and we're going to help Robert up to his feet. And then
STD, what do I do?
We'll come back after this.
Enjoy the space program.
Oh, yeah. Everybody now.
Is LoveLine on Outrageous Talk Radio 100.7 The Buzz.
It is the LoveLine. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. Robert Schimmel's our guest tonight. Robert has himself an HBO special, which is coming out this Saturday, called Robert Schimmel Unprotected, along with a CD out December 7th. Robert is a very funny stand-up, and you will see that tonight. Not tonight, actually. There'll be no comedy displayed tonight, but when you tune in on Saturday night at 10 o'clock on HBO, you will you'll see how funny it is. And this is, you've done, how many HBO specials?
This is my first. Well, I've been on one with Rodney Dangerfield a long time ago.
And this is an hour-long special, yeah. Right? It's not the half hour. So this is...
it's this, a real
this,
thing.
This means you've arrived.
Yeah.
When did you tape it?
About 7 weeks ago, 8 weeks ago.
Where did you tape
it? Kalamazoo State Theater.
How come?
It's a very good audience for me. Yeah, when my first CD came out, I sold like 5,000 CDs in Kalamazoo, Battle Creek, and Grand Rapids, and the rest of the country wasn't even 5,000 all put together.
Hmm.
They just went nuts for me, so I figured that would be a good place to do it, and it was.
And were you, how many seat venue? What kind of theater?
1,600.
Wow.
Sold out two shows in one night, and that's how we did it.
And when you do those HBO specials, don't they normally do two shows?
Yeah, that's what we did.
And you do like a 7 o'clock and a 9 o'clock show or something, and basically piece them together.
Yeah, so you try and do it all in one if you can, because otherwise if you're not in the same place doing the same joke and you move, then
right. It's
hard to cut to go to...
And you just basically take the stronger of the two shows, and that becomes a special. Were you happy with it?
Oh, yeah, I was very happy with it. They had the premiere party last night, but I couldn't watch it. There's like 250 people there, and I had to walk out when they showed it.
It's too freaky?
Yeah, you know, I've heard other actors on talk shows say, you know, I never watch any of my films, and I'm thinking, yeah, right. And
right.
Here I am at this thing, and there it's starting, and I had to walk outside in the parking lot.
But everyone had a good time and laughed their ass off,
so.
Right?
Yeah.
How many years have you been doing stand-up?
19.
I'm just making small talk so it doesn't fall on the floor.
And your
sign is?
You know, I can't.
He's afraid to put another call on.
No, I'm going to be all right now. Look, that call just dropped me. I couldn't help it.
Drew, let's see if we can get like an AIDS call or something.
Oh. Yeah.
Melissa?
Yeah.
You're 17?
Well, almost 18, yeah.
All right. You got a 20-year-old boyfriend?
Yeah.
And you can't last more than 5 minutes?
5 or 10 on average, yeah. I mean, there's been a couple times that lasted longer, but normally it doesn't last longer than 5 or 10 minutes.
Yeah, and it's always been this way?
Yeah.
And you've been having sex for how long?
About a year and 2 months.
Mm-hmm. And does he do any oral sex?
Yeah.
He does?
Yeah.
Because that's when you should start the clock. And you punch in as soon as you start the oral sex.
In fact, Adam, you've been insisting upon that for so long now. It's beginning to make me think that you're a little compensating in some way.
No, I'm telling you, I don't lie on this show unless it's about embarrassing things that would make me look bad. My penis will last as long as I want it to last.
But you're kind of lazy and you'd rather use the mouth, or what are you saying?
No, I'm saying that I know women like oral sex more than they like intercourse.
I see. You choose it. I see.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Right. I have to give them what they like.
Okay, got
it. For the first 3 weeks of the relationship, and then I slide to my comfort zone, which is I watch TV while they give me oral sex. But Melissa?
Uh-huh.
So how is he at the oral sex?
Pardon me?
How is he at oral sex?
Great.
Oh, he is?
Yeah.
Do you have an orgasm?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, you know, you're ahead of the game. So he has an early chi release program. That's all right.
Is normal, or if there's a reason that caused it, or
that's pretty normal. 10 minutes.
Well, between 5 and 10 is a little early. On the other hand, you get the orgasm. He's his chi runs free on the comforter. Everyone's happy, right?
Okay.
Okay. I mean, maybe could he try masturbating? You know, an hour before he had sex.
I never asked him.
Why don't you see? Maybe you can add a little.
Okay.
Or you can do my other plan. What is it? The poster of the Hey Vern guy on the ceiling. We'll always add, like 7-8 minutes to lovemaking. Doesn't necessarily make it better, but it just adds to it. All right. You know what you need? You know, guys, you remember that? Clockwork Orange?
Yeah.
Remember that scene where they, you know, had his eyes peeled open, back, yeah, and they had that montage of, like, Jews going into ovens and trains crashing into each other? I think if guys, like, ran that reel on their ceiling while they were making love, they could add a good 6-8 minutes to the lovemaking. Lisa?
Yes.
You're 24. What's up?
Hi. Just one comment for Robert Schimmel. I just saw you tonight at the Brea Improv.
Yeah.
You must have driven really fast. Did you have to drive really fast to get there on time?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
Okay, because I'm a state trooper.
Oh, good.
How was he at the Brea Improv?
He was great. I was sort of busy. It wasn't really busy, but he did really well.
Did he just roll around and laugh for like an hour and 20 minutes?
No, he didn't. He was he's very calm in his act.
Yeah. It's a funny act, though, isn't it?
It is very funny.
Good.
Thank you very much.
I have a question for Dr. Drew.
Mm-hmm.
My boyfriend and I have been dating for about 3 months now, and we have had maybe, I don't know, a handful of successful, shall we say, encounters, I guess. He can't get it up. He has a, I don't know, it'll come up, and then, I'm sorry, I'm kind of nervous, but he will sometimes be able to last maybe, I don't know, halfway through, and then he'll lose it, or he just won't be able to get it up at all.
Does he do drugs?
No. He doesn't.
Is he on medication?
Not that I know of, no. And I do spend a lot of time with him. I have never seen him take any medication at all.
How old is he?
30.
Have you asked him about this?
I have, and he says that he doesn't know why he has this problem, and he does smoke. Does that have anything to do with it?
Well, smoke like crazy, like 3 packs a day?
No. He smokes maybe a pack a day or less, maybe probably like 19.
I mean, it doesn't help. It probably helps significantly.
Has he had this problem before?
He says he hasn't, but I don't know if he's telling me the truth or not, but he says...
Guys work this angle, and it's a horrible angle, that, hey, my dicks work for everyone but you, honey. She's already feeling a little bit
insecure,
and you just sort of nailed the coffin shut, you know?
Really?
Well, I mean, I understand guys want to salvage some pride, so they go, I don't know what's going on. This has never happened to me before. But they're really saying the worst thing the woman wants to hear, because she then thinks it's her fault. I mean, do the math.
I know. I didn't think it was my fault. I mean, he says he's extremely attracted to me, and I don't feel that it's my fault, but I've asked him. I said, did you ever have this problem before? And he said no. He said he was just as baffled as I was.
Well, what about like Viagra for a guy like this?
It's a possibility, but again, at 30, he should have an evaluation for medical causes of this first.
Really?
Yeah, first. Especially if it's a new problem.
Does he masturbate?
He says he doesn't masturbate that often.
Does
And he said he doesn't really masturbate that often. And I've just said, you know, it's okay. I don't really care if you do, but why, you know, why wouldn't you? And he said he doesn't very often.
Has he had, what about oral sex? How's that work? I mean, when you do it to him.
He works better. Let's put it that way. He works better when I do go down on him. It seems like that's easier.
Mm-hmm.
Him to, you know, get off himself is when I go down on him.
Can you finish him off that way?
Yeah, I do usually, but it seems to work.
What do you do with the chi? Is that the going to the ficus plant or the sink or or into you?
I swallow it.
Oh, you do? Good. Now you have the power.
So it's empty. Yeah, anyway.
All right. So, maybe you should get evaluated.
Mm-hmm.
It's interesting, though. The penis seems to work during the oral sex.
It does. It works better. Let's put it that way. And he's always asking for that. It seems to be the main, like, intercourse that he can't.
But it sounds like the erectile function has been sort of geared down.
Yeah.
Like, it can work in the optimal zone, but it doesn't work the rest of the time, and it's a change for him.
Right.
And it's worth a medical evaluation. It may just be he's, God knows what. I mean, there's something in him emotionally that's affecting his ability to perform. But first and foremost, it's to make sure there's not some medical cause for this.
And it
maybe it's a psychological thing with the mouth. Why don't you put a set of false teeth in your vagina and see if that doesn't do the trick.
Dentata. But he's held this relationship 3-4 months?
It makes sense to me.
Yeah.
There's a lot to be learned about him yet, and maybe there's more here than we know.
True.
Okay? And,
it's not his smoking, though, right?
Not at that age. Not yet.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
It's about 30, 40 pack years to get under your belt.
Right. All right. Let's
I like that when a doctor says God knows what. That's really reassuring.
Yeah, thank God she called, huh? Amy?
Yeah?
You're 24.
I am.
What's up?
What's up? Don't you know? No. I masturbate a lot.
You do?
Ever since I was a senior in high school.
What are you good for a day? What can we put you down for?
On your tally, Adam?
Yeah.
Well, lately my boyfriend's been working out of town. During the week, so I have.
I don't qualify. Just give me a number.
Okay. 8 to 12 times.
A day?
Yeah.
Really? That's pretty good. And you sleep 14 hours a day, so let me do the math.
It's about 9, 10 hours a day.
Wow.
Sleep. Active.
I bet she sleeps well.
10 hours a day. Yeah.
I usually go to bed around 10. I get up at 8.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And do you have to wake up to masturbate in order to keep that tally going?
If I have time in the morning, I'll masturbate. Ever since I was a senior, my parents got this back massager. Looks like a large dildo.
Yeah, I know those things.
And ever since my first sexual experience, I had a boyfriend in high school. I never was able to get off with him.
Right.
I never did. I didn't know what an orgasm was supposed to be. I just knew you made a noise and you said, oh, yeah, okay, and it was over.
Yeah, that's about it, yeah.
And sex wasn't...
Right, but now, so can you have an orgasm with a man?
I have seldomly with my boyfriend now. I've been with him for 3 years.
Okay, so you're 10 or 12 times a day with the masturbation.
If I have the time.
Yeah. Using the magic wand, or is this by hand, or what are you using?
Well, I'm using the magic wand.
You are.
Out of town.
Would you sneak it out of your parents' house, or you just buy a new one?
No. Well, I live in my own house now. I bought my own house this year, and
you got your own vibrator.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I.
Great. It didn't come with the house, did it?
No.
It's better than visiting your parents and going, my back went out again.
Yeah, jeez.
They go 8 times a day your back goes out.
Hey.
I don't know what it is, but the orgasm is more intense and it's better. And my question is it, because I'm not having these type of orgasms when I have sex. We have awesome sex. We have great sex.
Okay, well, you sound a little compulsive, Amy, with the 10 or 12 times a day. Although with women, the orgasm, it's a never-ending power source. It's like solar power.
No chi released.
Yeah, there's no chi. Yeah. It really is. It's like guys' orgasms, it sort of like would be like fossil fuel. It's a finite...
Depleting resource.
It's women.
But she relieves the body.
Women, it's just like, it's like solar power. They're ready to go. There's nothing lost.
Well, I mean, I can have multiple orgasms, you know?
Oh, really? Okay, but, you know, here's the thing, Amy. Here's my take.
Okay.
You're used to this Panasonic thing that's operating at, you know, 5,000 RPMs a second, and there's no man that can compete with this thing. There just isn't. Huh?
Should I put it down?
I think you should put it down because...
Why not bring it in?
Oh, we have.
You have?
Yes.
And how's that work?
Well, you know, I mean, we have toys, we have vibrators, and we use also the massager.
Does that help you?
Yeah. Of course. I mean, that's how I usually can get off when I masturbate alone. But I can't have the intense orgasms like when he goes down on me as I can with this vibrator.
Right. Unless you put it in his ass and you get his whole face shaking, right? All right, listen, Amy, why don't you cut back on the masturbation? I've never said that in my life, but I'm taking a stand here. Why don't you see if you can trim it back to just, say, a paltry 8 times a day for a while. See how that goes.
So does it cause, do you think...
I think you're desensitized.
Yes, you can desensitize.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I figured.
You understand?
Yeah.
I mean, you got to look at it this way. Her clitoris is moving... like, you know, hummingbird's wings. You know what I mean? With this Panasonic on it. I mean, it's like a pad sander.
Yeah, you know what happens to guys that operate jackhammers? Hands go numb.
They don't have feeling in their hands anymore.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Her clitoris is carpal tunnel syndrome in it. It's an operation. All right. We're going to take a little break. Robert, you've been doing very well.
Thanks.
You're sitting upright.
Concentrating.
You're focused. You're a new man. We're going to take a little break. Robert Schimmel's our guest tonight. Unprotected's the name of the CD, which will be out December 7th. Also, the HBO one-hour special, which will be out this Saturday at 10 o'clock. And let me tell you something about Robert. He don't mind cussing or telling dirty stories, but it's all good. It's not gratuitous. We'll take a little break. Even if it is, it's still good. I don't mean he doesn't use, you know, the F word or the S word or talk about banging his wife for shock value. It's funny. And it's blue. And I like that. We'll be back after this.
LoveLine will be right back.
This is LoveLine on Outrageous Talk Radio, 100.7 The Buzz.
It is LoveLine. I'm Adam. That is Drew. Robert Schimmel is our guest tonight. He has a special coming up this Saturday, 10 o'clock on HBO. Also, his CD, Unprotected, will be released December 7th. And let's speak to... I want to speak to Jason over here. See a call line number two there, Drew?
All right.
Jason, 26 years old?
Yeah.
Yeah. 7 years in jail?
Yeah, just got out about 2 weeks ago.
Started 19?
Huh, yeah.
What'd you do?
I broke in a few houses in my neighborhood and got caught.
That's it, huh?
Huh?
Did you have a bunch of priors or something?
No priors.
Just, you did 7 years for breaking into a few houses?
Yeah, they gave me 10 years. The judge told me that it was like a wake-up call to get my attention and basically forgot about me. You know, forgot that I was in the system. I got caught up in the system.
You didn't kill anyone that was in the house that you broke into?
No, didn't. I stole a tent out of one house and a couple pillows and a sleeping bag out of another house. I was living in the woods with my girlfriend.
You did 7 years stealing camping equipment?
Yeah, basically what it is. I did 7 years and 2 months on a 10-year sentence.
How old was she?
She was 17.
Is that legal?
Huh?
Was that legal?
I believe it is.
17-year-old and a 19-year-old?
I mean, I guess. I don't know.
Okay. All right.
But, I mean, the reason I called is, you know, I'm having a hard time adjusting back into society. You know, it's just everything seems real weird. I'm real paranoid around people again. You know, and, like, I'm on this thing called, like, mandatory probation.
Right. I know. It's a tough transition. He tried to buy a used car with cigarettes last week alone. He gave the guy a couple of cartons. He didn't understand why he couldn't drive off the lot. Yeah, it's...
I mean, I'm trying to find, you know, there's, I don't know any kind of, anybody I can get in touch with, anybody I can talk to. You know, my family's trying to be supportive of me, but they, you know, they're just, I can't connect with them. They can't relate to me. I can't relate to them anymore.
Did you learn a trade while you're in prison?
No. Maryland prisons, they don't, they just, you know, it's rehabilitation through boredom. They just warehouses.
So you didn't just watch TV and...
Watch TV and read and...
That's it, huh?
I spent most of the time I was in prison on lockup. I got in a lot of fights and stayed in a lot of trouble.
Hey, I kind of got the feeling, the idea that you ended up doing 7.5 years for stealing a lantern seems like maybe it caused a little trouble once you got in.
Yeah, well, I mean, it was tough for me coming in, being so young and being small and being white. You know, I had to do a lot of fighting.
Right.
You know, I mean, that's what life in prison meant for me, standing up and fighting, or, you know, the alternative, I wasn't trying to deal with that.
Right.
And,
Right, I understand. So you end up doing more time than maybe you needed to do.
Well, so what is it you're experiencing now when you try to assimilate? What's making it difficult?
It's just frustration. You know, I mean, I've been trying to get a job. I've been humping around the town, trying, you know, applying to places. And I come across the section on application about have you ever been convicted of a prior, you know, felony in the past such and such years or whatever. And, you know, I get stuck. You know, I say, should I lie? Should I be honest with
you? Yeah, I'd lie.
Well, I mean...
That's easy. You lie.
Yeah.
Does the system offer you any assistance in all this?
None. I have this probation officer I speak to, and I've been calling him, telling him, look, you know, I'm having problems. You know, can you? Is there somewhere I can go to? Somewhere I can talk to? You know, because I feel overwhelmed right now.
Yeah.
And you know, there's nothing. He's telling me there's nothing. I have to deal with it. I'm a man now. I have to deal with.
Well, where do you live?
I live in Maryland.
Yeah, but what kind of place in Maryland?
It's just Charles County, Southern Maryland, like Hicksville.
In an apartment?
No, I live in a house, my parents' house.
So you're back at home?
Yeah.
Well, at least you bought a little time with your parents. I mean.
I need somebody to hold my hand right now. You know, just coming out and, you know, and I appreciate the help that my family's given me. But.
All right. Listen, Robert. How long have you been out?
About 2.5 weeks.
Okay.
All right, it's just getting started.
You're putting a little too much pressure on yourself. You know,
you've got a place to stay. You've got a way to get food.
Right.
That's good.
Don't do anything stupid. Go put in some applications. I know you can work construction. Everyone I worked with in construction was had priors. That's why they wouldn't hire them otherwise. You understand?
Yeah.
That's part of the criteria. And lie on your application.
All right,
they never look into it. You don't have that teardrop tattoo, do you?
No,
because then they might check it out. They see the teardrop tattoo, they do a background check. But he sounds all right. You know what? Wear a bow tie. And there's no ex-cons that wear bow ties anymore. You should guys show up in a bow tie, fill out an application. They're not going to check it out. What are we doing here, Drew?
There's Alyssa and her boyfriend, Troy.
Oh, did Alyssa call in earlier?
Yeah. Alyssa?
Yeah.
You called in the very opening of the show, didn't you?
Yes.
What was the question again?
That seemed like 2 days ago.
Yeah.
what was the question?
Troy wanted me to call back in, and he wanted to explain his side of the
breathing.
Story to you. And then...
You hear him?
Let me hear it from his point and what you had to say for him.
All right.
Troy?
Yes.
What was the original problem? I can't remember.
The original problem was I have a problem climaxing. Mm-hmm. And sometimes lately and stuff, I've been having a problem even getting it erect.
Right.
And I've had the problem with climaxing ever since the very first time having sex. It's been happening since I was 17.
All right, well, somehow, I think she told us this was a brand new thing.
That's probably part of the message that wasn't communicated back. I've had this problem since I was 17. There's one time where I was with somebody else, and it was a one thing, and it was boom, and it was like real quick, and you know. But every other time I've had sex, right. I usually had a hard time climaxing.
Well, that guy probably had an exceptionally tight ass or something. you never know when you're going to run into one of those.
Once in a while, I have no problem, but usually it takes an exceptional amount of time.
Okay, so this is nothing unusual.
Not for me, no.
And then she also meant you're under a lot of stress and working hard lately, right?
Yeah.
And so that's compounding the problem.
That's what I thought.
Yeah, that would make sense.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
There's no problem with the sensitivity or anything like that. Is there anything that I can do to help this?
As usual, women like to blame themselves for these things. Yeah.
Elise, you have a sister?
I'm sorry.
She's 8 years old, but...
I'm not even going there.
So when I'm 40, she's 13. Okay. All right.
But,
so, is there anything Elisa can do?
I pretty much say it's an issue with me.
Right.
And I know it is because I've had this problem all my life.
All right.
And it does bother me at some points because I know it bothers her. And I'm not, and sometimes I'm like, I'm 24 and I should be going like a jackrabbit and I feel like I'm going like I'm 45.
She also said you were sort of generally down and your sexual energy was just sort of down.
It varies a lot.
Okay.
It varies a lot.
Then that's always been that way.
Yeah, it's always been that way. Especially with like the masturbation thing. There were times I'd go without doing it for 6 months and then there were times...
Ooh, you're offending Adam's sensibilities now. Careful.
Yeah, I go three or four times a day for a while, and then I'd probably stop for...
Listen, I have it my will that I get a hand job for the first 3 weeks after I'm dead, just to sort of keep things going, just to see if it brings any life into me.
Any chi comes
Six
back.
6 months at 20,
yeah, but then
23,
then he said he'll cycle down to he's doing four times a day.
Okay.
So he's...
That I can live with.
Maybe it's my bipolar illness, something like that. Anyway.
All right. We can't live in the past,
no,
Drew. Let's take a quick break, and we'll be back.
I feel so good.
You're listening to Loveline with Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew. Loveline will be right back.
All right, this is it. The show is officially over. Robert Schimmel, thank you very much for coming in. Unprotected is the name of the CD out December 7th, and do not miss the HBO special this Saturday, 10 o'clock, of course, on HBO with the very funny Robert Schimmel.
Thank you.
Thanks, Robert. You come in when you're in condition to do the radio. anytime. Always good to see you. Until next time, this is Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew saying mahalo.
Mommy.
This has been Loveline. The views expressed on Loveline are not necessarily those of the staff, the management, or the sponsors of this radio station.
And are probably not the views of Westwood One Entertainment.
Loveline is produced by Ann Wilkins Engel.
Now, please listen to this station longer.